Strainers are used almost in every type of industrial piping system just to protect downstream equipment from the particle fluid flowing through the fluid. It just filters the particle and protect downstream equipment. There are several type of strainers. Say this is a Y strainer and this we call conical strainer. This is a double cone type strainer, one cone inside and one cone outside. This is a basket type strainer and this is a T type strainer. There are 5-6 type of strainer most commonly used in the industry. See, this is a conical strainer. This side is the cone and this side is mounted inside the flange here. This is the cone. And this we call perforated seat. See, this perforated seat is having approx 6 mm dia perforated holes at the rate of 8 to 9 mm each. This is another conical strainer, same thing, same shape, same conical strainer, and this portion is mounted in between two flanges and gasket is provided here. This is the handle. Same thing, conical strainer again. This is a special type of conical strainer having double cone. You can see here, one cone is this one and another cone is here. In this picture also, this is one cone and this is another cone. This type of strainer is called double cone conical strainer. This is just to increase the flow area within short length of strainer. Another conical strainer of double cone type. See, this is big one, outer cone, and this is small one, inner cone. So strainer length is this much, only this much, but surface area will be huge so that your space requirement will be less. Now flow direction. See, conical strainer is installed in this manner. This is a flange spool. Here will be another flange spool. Cone is mounted like this and fluid is flowing like this. This is the flange spool and this cone is inserted in this flange spool, and in this condition flow is from this side to that side. And over this perforated seat, we are base is wrapped, that we call screened. You can see flow direction, flow from this side. This is one flange connection, this is another flange connection, and this is the cone. Next, Y type strainer. It is a Y type strainer, flange name type, cast body. You can see cast body. Here it is written CF8M, that means SS316, CF8M. This side one flange, that side another flange. So in this case, fluid is coming like this. Then basket is there like this and again going like this. This is Y strainer. One port is there, drain port here with plug. You can see here this Y strainer clearly. Fluid inlet is from this direction, then it is coming to this basket, and from this basket is going outside, then it is finally going out. Strainer inlet from this side. And this is the perforated cylinder. Fluid comes from this side, inlet, and it goes out this direction, this direction, this direction, and finally it goes out to this direction. This is the outlet. So, in the basic difference of conical strainer and Y strainer is, in case of conical strainer, screen is mounted over the conical strainer, and in case of Y strainer or basket strainer, screen is mounted inside of this perforated seat, inside, not outside, because fluid is coming like this and going out. Another point, see, this Y strainer is of cast body. You can see from here it is of cast body, but this Y strainer has been fabricated from pipe. You can see the joint over here, pipe to pipe joint. This cast body strainer looks very good, but this fabricated strainer looks odd. But why it has been made? Because in case of this cast body strainer, surface area of this screen will be lower. But in case of fabricated wire strainer, surface area of this screen will be much more. That's why sometimes vendor prefer to give this type of fabricated wire strainer. This is another type of strainer. It is called T-strainer. See, this is a T-piece. This side is flanged, this side is flanged, and this side is flanged, and this is the element. This is the element, this is the perforated seat. In this case, liquid comes from this side, go inside, and liquid going out from here, and finally go out. This T-strainer always to be installed in horizontal plane. Another picture of T-strainer, you can see here, this is actually the element. Liquid is coming here, and after filtering, it is going like this. Another picture, this is the T-piece, and inside element is like this. While opening, you open this, the element will come out, and you can clean it. This is another type of strainer called basket strainer. See, it is like a basket. Liquid is coming here and going inside to the basket. This is the element, cylindrical element. Liquid is coming, then liquid going out in all direction like this, all direction, then finally going out. For removing basket, one handle is there and pipeline is connected here by plane joint and here by plane joint. This is called basket strainer. This is a big view of basket strainer. See, this is the basket for opening the element. This handle is there. You can open the flange joint or the hinge joint and open it. Pipeline is connected here by flange joint this side and that side. And this one is the basket. You can see this is the element with perforated seat. Liquid come in like this, go inside. Then liquid goes out in every direction, then finally go out. In this case also, as like wire strainer, screen is inside of this perforated seat, not on outside. This is small type of basket strainer, up to say 8 inch or 10 inch or 12 inch. For this type of basket strainer, flanged end type, but no removal system is there. This is a picture of large type basket strainer, like 20 inch, 24 inch, like that. In this case, divot arrangement has been provided here so that this top portion can be removed and can be rotated like this. Then you can open the element for cleaning. This is called divot. You can see here that divot arrangement clearly. This is in closed condition and this is in open condition. This upper portion has been rotated with the help of divot, and this is the screen or element being removed. This is the drawing for the divot arrangement. Another type of divot arrangement also possible. In this case, this is a hinge type divot. Here it will not be rotated like this, it will be rotated like this. It will be rotated like this. You just open like this, then you open the element.
Now you can have a look to this video of basket type strainer. You can clearly see how particles are filtered in this basket strainer.
This is another type of strainer, we call it duplex strainer. For this type of strainer, no shutdown time is required. Two three-way valve is there. One is here, another is here. Say liquid is coming here, going like this and coming out. Then this portion is under operation. If you want to maintain this filter, then you rotate this three-way valve so that this portion will be operating. Liquid will come here, go like this and go like this. So you don't need any shutdown time. You can clean it as online. Now, which type of strainer to be used in which service? See, this type of conical strainer is normally used as a temporary strainer, which is removed after commissioning. Even in some case, you can use it as a permanent also. But if you want to keep it as permanent, then You should provide this type of manhole here with a drain here. Otherwise, and another manhole that side also. Otherwise, every time during cleaning, you will have to open all these drain studs, bolts, then open it, then you will have to clean it. Better to provide one manhole this side, another handle that side, so that you clean it from this manhole, and one small valve is there, 2 inch or 3 inch, all debris will come out to the valve. Yeah. Voice strainer is quite robust, and tea strainer also quite robust, and those can be used for any service, any critical service. Now see a conical strainer. This is a small 1 inch conical strainer, and this is a perforated portion, 1.6 mm thick, and this is a screen. This is the screen of 40 mesh. 40 mesh means per inch 40 numbers of holes are there in this direction, and another 40 numbers of holes are there in this direction. That means in 1 inch square area 1600 square holes are there. Now while manufacturing, this perforated screen will be wrapped over this perforated sheet like this, and finally this will be welded here with this ring. So finally strainer will become like this. Liquid will come here and go out. Now coming to material of construction, first conical strainer. Since the cone is always mounted inside the pipe, so cone, that means perforated sheet, this perforated sheet and screen always of SS, stainless steel. Only for oxygen service, it is of monel or brass or bronze, because stainless steel strainer is not oxygen compatible. Since monel, brass or bronze, those are inert material, they will not react with oxygen. Then voice strainer. For voice strainer, body material is carbon steel for carbon steel piping, and of stainless steel for stainless steel piping. Body material shall be of cast carbon steel as per ASTM A216 grade WCB, and for stainless steel ASTM A351 grade CF8. But internals, that means element and screen, always of stainless steel. For normal ordinary services like cooling water, air, nitrogen, body is of carbon steel. And for any cryogenic service or other service where stainless steel requirement is there, body is of stainless steel. Similarly for basket strainer, this basket, body can be of carbon steel also from plate or from pipe, but this perforated sheet and screen always is of stainless steel. And for T strainer also, this T is a rod fittings, that means for carbon steel it will be as per ASTM A234 grade WPB, and for stainless steel T shall be of ASTM A403 WP304 or 304L, and flanges are, oil neck flanges are connected also. And always this screen and this perforated sheet shall be of stainless steel. Now see how to calculate open area of a strainer. As per good engineering practice, normally we keep open area as 2 times of pipe cross-sectional area. Suppose it is a 4-inch conical strainer. Left side diameter is 100 millimeter and right side diameter is say 20 millimeter and cone length is 300 millimeter. And this perforated sheet having 6 mm dia holes at the rate of 9 millimeter pitch. So now if you open the perforated sheet, then imagine it as a rectangle. Its length is 300 millimeter, this one 300 millimeter, and this width is average diameter of 120, that is 60 millimeter. So this side length is 188 millimeter and this side length is 300 millimeter. Now since pitch is 9 millimeter, so number of holes along length, it will be 32 numbers, and along with it will be 20 numbers. 180 divided by 9 is roughly 20. Now assume this perforated sheet as a rectangle having length equals to 300 millimeter and width equals to average diameter of D100 and D2, that is average diameter 60, that means pi D 188. So along length, total number of holes will be 300 divided by 9 pitch, 32 numbers, and along width, number of holes will be approximately 188 divided by 9, that is roughly 20 numbers. Now total number of holes equals to 32 into 20 equals to 640. Hence total open area of holes will be pi d square by 4 into 640, that is 18086 millimeter square. And our requirement is that open area should be more than 2 times of pipe cross sectional area. Now 2 times of 4 inch pipe cross sectional area equals to again pi d square by 4 into 2 times. You consider ID of 4 inch pipe as 100 mm. So pipe cross sectional area is 15700. That means our requirement is minimum 15700 millimeter square, and we are providing open area of 18086 millimeter square. So it is okay. Of Y strainer also, in the same manner you calculate number of holes. Say diameter of element is D and length is L, then in the same manner as like conical strainer, you draw a rectangle and then number of holes will be one side L by 9 and another side pi D by 9. In case of basket strainer also, you can calculate number of holes in the same manner with D as indicated and L as indicated, in the same manner as like conical strainer or as like Y strainer. Now we will see how pressure drop is calculated through a strainer for a particular fluid. It is calculated by a simple formula like this: delta P equals to Pw into fluid density divided by density of water into one coefficient, that is 0.00379 V plus 1. That means first pressure drop is calculated for water, then pressure drop is calculated for the fluid considering its viscosity in centistoke CSP. Now how pressure drop of water will be calculated? It is calculated from a chart. You can see this type of chart manufacturers gives us for a 80 ms. This is a typical chart. You can see 80 ms chart. This side is flow in liter per minute, and this size is pressure drop in MPa. This is delta P MPa, and this size is the nominal pipe size. This is 150 NB, this is 100 NB, this is 80 NB, this is like this, this is 25 NB. So this is a flow rate versus pressure drop chart. This is for clear water, you can see clear water, and for 80 ms size. Now let us take an example. Say 300 LPM, that means 180 meter cube per hour of a lubricating oil is flowing through a 80 ms strainer of 6 inch size, that means 150 NB size, then what will be the pressure drop? So lubricating oil density is 900 kg per meter cube, and lubricating oil kinematic viscosity is 200 centistoke. Then from this chart, you first calculate pressure drop of 300 LPM of water through a 80 ms strainer. See here, it is 300 LPM is here, this is 300 LPM, then it is 150 NB size. So for 300 LPM, the pressure drop is 0.03 MPa. Then you come back here. So from the chart, we have got that for water, pressure drop is 0.03 MPa, that means 0.3 kg per centimeter square. Then pressure drop for lubricating oil flow will be delta P equals to lube density divided by water density into that factor 0.00379 g plus 1. By doing this, you will get 0.47 kg per centimeter square. So while water will flow through this 80 ms strainer, its pressure drop will be 0.3 kg per centimeter square. But when lube oil will flow through this strainer having more viscosity, it is little bit more viscous fluid than water, then pressure drop will be little bit more. It will be 0.47 kg per centimeter square. In this manner, pressure drop is calculated. Now, for a conical strainer, we should have a check of collapse pressure. That means at what pressure the strainer will collapse. Normally, vendor gives us perforated sheet of 1.6 mm thick or 2 mm thick. Maybe for 2 inch also, vendor is giving 1.6 mm thick perforated sheet. And 20 inch also, for 20 inch also, vendor is giving 2 mm thick perforated sheet. But we should cross check it at what pressure the strainer will collapse. Suppose a conical strainer having D equals to 200 mm, that means 8 inch conical strainer, perforated sheet is of 14 SWG, 2 mm thick, and length is 300 mm. So this calculation is based on external pressure. The strainer is a conical shell and calculate maximum value of allowable external pressure as per ASME section 8 division 1 UG 28. Now T, perforated sheet thickness is 2 mm, length equals to 300 mm, D0 is 200 mm, L by D0 equals to 300 by 200, 1.5, D0 by T equals to 200 by 21. From figure G of ASME section 2 part D, subpart 3, determine the value of factor A from L by D0 versus D0 by T curve. In this case, L by D0 equals to 1.5 and D0 by T is 100, so factor A will be 0.0009. Then from figure A1 of ASME section 2 part D, subpart 3, determine value of factor B, that is a temperature versus factor A curve. For temperature of 48 degrees Celsius and factor A of 0.009 from curve, factor B value will be 60. So maximum allowable external pressure, that is collapse pressure as per ASME section 8 division 1 will be TA allowable pressure equals to 4B by 3 into D0 by T, that is 0.5 MPa, that means 8 kg per centimeter square. That means up to 8 bar gauge, this conical strainer will not collapse. Now we have seen collapse pressure calculation of conical strainer. But for Y strainer and basket strainer, the calculation is for bursting pressure, because for basket strainer and Y strainer, flow is from inside to outside. That means pressure is inside. That's why the term bursting is coming. Now the calculation. As per ASME section 8 division 1, under internal pressure, required thickness T equals to PR divided by SE minus 0.6P, where P equals to internal design pressure, say 10 bar gauge, E equals to oil joint efficiency, normally 0.85, R equals to inside radius of strainer, that is 300 by 2, 150 mm, S allowable stress for stainless steel is 1400 kg per centimeter square, T is required minimum thickness, and as per calculation, T is coming as 1.2 millimeter. Now if vendor provides 2 mm thick perforated sheet, then by back calculation we can get bursting pressure also by a formula, P equals to SET divided by R plus 0.60. It will be 15.74 kg per centimeter square. That means if vendor provides 2 mm thick perforated sheet, then this dimension, this dimensional, this, then this strainer will be capable of taking internal pressure of 15.74 kg per centimeter square. Now you can see figure G of ASME. One side is L by D0 and curves are D0 by T. And from this table you can get factor A. Two sheets are there. Then this is HA1, figure HA1. From this you can get factor B based on factor A. Then various perforated sheet parameters, that means hole dia, hole pitch and percentage of total hole area on sheet, you can get from these two, three tables. Then wear mesh or screen parameters. We know mesh, what is mesh. Then wear dia, mesh, opening in inch and relation between mesh and micron. All this you can get from this table. That means say 2 mesh means 11,100 micron, 100 mesh means 141 micron, 150 mesh means 105 micron, 170 mesh means 79 micron, like that. From these figures you can get all these parameters of the strainer. I think I have clearly explained various type of strainers, their use, their collapse pressure calculation, their bursting pressure calculation and pressure drop through the strainers also. I think all things I have covered clearly.